Bismillahirrahmanirrahim. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Salam sejahtera, salam kasih, salam IPGM KTHO kelas pertama 2025 dan salam Malaysia Madani. Yang berusaha, Dr. Muhammad Nordin bin Abu Bakar, pengarah IPGM Campus Tun Sen On. Yang dihormati, ketua-ketua jabatan, ketua-ketua unit, para pensyarah, semua staf warga IPG Campus Tun Sen On dan tuan-puan semua yang berada di hadapan layar sekalian. Kata orang tak kenal maka tak cinta, saya Muhammad Daniel bin Yusaini, pelajar daripada Campus Tun Sen On, Option Bahasa Melayu Ambilan Jun 2023, selaku moderator pada pagi ini. Alhamdulillah, setinggi-tinggi kesyukuran dipanjat kehadrat Ilahi kerana dengan izin dan limpah kurnianya, kita dapat menjalankan webinar Wacana Ilmiah 4.0 pada kali ini. Tema Wacana Ilmiah ini adalah Pendidikan Madani, Aspirasi Pembangunan Karamah Insaniah. Bagi menambahkan keberkatan majlis, mari kita sama-sama mulakan majlis ini dengan bacaan Ummul Kitab. Al-Fatihah. Amin, amin, ya Rabbal Alamin. Tuan-puan yang dihormati sekalian, untuk makluman semua, program Wacana Ilmiah 4.0 ini merupakan anjuran Jabatan Perancangan, Penyelidikan dan Inovasi IPGM Campus Tun Hussein On. Tuan-puan yang saya hormati sekalian, tanpa membuang masa lagi, dengan segala hormatnya, saya memperkenalkan panel kita pada pagi ini, iaitu Dr. Ki Li Li. Beliau merupakan salah seorang pensyarah di IPGM Campus Tun Sen On. Tajuk perkongsian beliau pada kali ini ialah Effectiveness of E-book Writing Software on TESOL Pre-Service Teachers ESL Academic Writing Performance. Untuk makluman semua, sekiranya ada sebarang pertanyaan, bolehlah diajukan di ruangan chat YouTube. Jawapan beliau akan dimasukkan semula ke dalam ruangan chat oleh pihak urus setia. Dipersilakan.
A very good morning to everyone and all. Thank you so much for having me. Today, I am going to share a research with the title Effectiveness of E-book Writing Software on TESOL Pre-Service Teachers ESL Academic Writing Performance. I am Dr. Ki Li Li from the Institute of Teacher Education Malaysia, Tun Hussein On Campus. Structure of presentation. Number 1. Background of the study. Number 2. Statement of the problem. Number 3. Proposed treatment. Number 4. I Spring. Number 5. Process-based approach and digital literacies. Number 6. Research questions. Number 7. Research hypothesis. Number 8. Literature review. Number 9. Research method. Number 10. Research participants. Number 11. Research framework. Number 12. Findings and discussion. Number 13. Implications of the study. Number 14. Some suggestions for further research. And finally, comes the conclusion. Background of the study. According to English Language Standards and Quality Council, ELSQC in 2015. Emphasis given on writing in Malaysian English education. However, learners' deficiency as writers is evident. Among the many learners, there is still much room for improvement in terms of ESL writing. Also, according to English Language Standards and Quality Council in 2015, 43% of primary school teachers were positioned at only band 2 in 2013 for teaching knowledge tests. It is evident that the teachers, they need to increase their teaching pedagogies to enable them to teach writing better to their learners in primary schools nationwide. Statement of the problem. According to Malaysian Education Blueprint in 2013, teachers' low writing proficiency escalates students' low writing performance. To enable students to perform better in their writing, teachers themselves, they must be good in their writing proficiency. According to AGITA 2006, recursiveness is found missing from writing process. More often than not, process-based approach, which is commonly used in schools. Process-based approach is always implemented in a linear manner, and the crucial writing process stages are always found missing. And finally, Yunus Atul 2012 noted that efforts are needed to improve learners' writing proficiency and teachers' writing pedagogies. With teachers securing writing pedagogies, then only they will be able to impart the writing skills to their learners to enable them to write more adequately. Hence, the proposed treatment for this study, it is of the amalgamation of digital literacies and process-based approach via the digital tool, namely iSpring, with process-based approach module to result in the utilization of e-book writing software in which the pre-service teachers write academic papers as an e-book using different modality. The modality here, it refers to the use of e-book publication. MOOCs refers to the use of text as well as images. And the media refers to the e-book writing software. And the pre-service teachers go through a writing process which is implemented in a recursive manner. This is how iSpring software looks like. The underpinning theories, here I focus on process-based approach and digital literacies. The synergy of these two important theories, it is evident, in which process-based approach, as proposed by White and Aunt in 1991, consists of six writing process stages, namely, generating ideas, focusing, structuring, reviewing, evaluating, and drafting. And digital literacies are being made evident via the process-based approach module, in which there are templates for the participants to utilize in each and every writing process stage. So, it is obvious here, the writing process stages, they are implemented generally in a sequence and done in a recursive manner in which the participants move back and forth the writing process stages. Research questions. Number one, how effective is the use of e-book writing software on the TESOL pre-service teachers' ESL academic writing performance? Number two, in what ways, if at all, does the use of e-book writing software affect the TESOL pre-service teachers' ESL academic writing? The research hypothesis. Research hypothesis number one, there is a statistically significant difference in the means of pre- and post-test ESL academic writing scores for the treatment group. Research hypothesis number two, there is a statistically significant difference in the population means of post-test ESL academic writing scores between the treatment and control groups. The literature review for the study. There are two main areas, namely ESL academic writing in Malaysian education. For example, according to Por Mohammadi et al. In 2012 and Rahman in 2017. Recursive nature of writing process found missing. Writing process simplified. More often than not, although process-based approach is commonly used, the recursiveness is always found missing due to the practice of implementing the process-based approach in a sequence or in a linear manner. According to What and Aunt 1991, writing process-based approach consists of six writing process stages, namely generating ideas, focusing, structuring, evaluating, drafting, and reviewing. However, more often than not, when process-based approach, when writing process is being used, the writing process is often simplified with the crucial writing process stages found missing from the writing process. Okay? Right, in terms of digital technologies in ESL writing, such as according to June and Lee in 2012 and Zakaria et al. In 2016, there is a scarcity of studies on the use of e-book writing software to write e-books as products of ESL writing, which closely incorporating process-based approach in a recursive manner. Traditional writing is very common, but writing e-books as a product of ESL writing, it is rare. The research method of this study, quasi-experimental design, non-equivalent control group pre-test post-test design, in which it is quantitative in nature, and this study opts for naturally formed group through purposive sampling. The research participants, there were 40 TESOL pre-service teachers in two intake classes. There were 20 TESOL pre-service teachers per class. Namely, the control group and the treatment group. And there were 7 males and 33 females from the second semester of the 1 year TESOL preparation program of bachelor's degree in teaching TESOL. The research participants were sourced from one Institute of Teacher Education Malaysia, ITEM, Quintessential Campus. A pseudonym was used for the study. The research framework. At the beginning of week one, pre-tests were administered to the research participants. From week 1 to week 10, the participants were required to write students' essays. There were two groups, treatment as well as non-treatment or control group. For treatment group, the use of e-book writing software in which process-based approach was used with the utilization of e-book writing software, whereby for non-treatment group, the participants underwent academic paper writing lessons by using only process-based approach without the utilization of e-book writing software. By the end of week 10, post-tests were being administered to the two groups. So basically, data collection was completed in 10 weeks' time. So here, this is the findings. What we can see here is the comparison within treatment group and also comparison between treatment and control groups. So the analysis, we have paired samples t-test and also independent samples t-test in which the test yield statistically significant differences with large effect. And this further point to the effectiveness of the treatment, the utilization of e-book writing software. So in what ways does the e-book writing software help to promote ESL academic writing? So here I will only touch on one part, which is promoting correct use of vocabulary and grammar. So this is the screenshot of one e-book, okay, two pages, page 6 and page 7, of one research participant. And it is very obvious here, ladies and gentlemen, you can see quite a number of grammatical errors identified by the lecturer, right, which are being highlighted. And the lecturer further provides feedback in terms of hints or cues given to the research participants. For example, number 9, there is a Concord error. So upon obtaining the feedback from the lecturer, the research participant further corrects the grammatical error. So here, this is the second complete draft, and it is obvious that upon obtaining the feedback provided, right? So the research participant improves in terms of the grammar, and also use of vocabulary. Okay, next, the implications of the study. The implications of the study is divided into two: practical implications as well as theoretical implications. In terms of practical implications, technology in academic writing. This study proposed an eclectic approach in which digital technologies are being amalgamated with process-based approach, right, in this study, to result in an approach which is not commonly practiced in primary ESL classrooms in Malaysia. In terms of policy and curricula, there is a need to restructure the course outline, especially to make process-based approach more obvious. Okay, this refers to the curriculum of writing curriculum, right? And in terms of writing software designer, there is a possibility to embed process writing approach, process-based approach via a module in that particular software. Next, let us move on to theoretical implications. In this study, we could see the synergy of theories, of the underpinning theories, especially of process-based approach and digital technologies, and In this study too, we witnessed the increased recursiveness of process-based approach, in which the possibility of moving back and forth the writing process stages is being made more evident, more possible, no? For the participants to write. For example, the participant generates ideas, and then he or she moves on to focusing and restructuring, and suddenly there is a new idea, and this is being made possible with the utilization of ebook writing software. The research participant could just insert the new idea to the piece of writing that he or she is producing. Right? Some suggestions for further research. This study does not apply random sampling, so it is suggested that random sampling is being used for further research, and it is good to include delayed post-test to see the durability of the treatment. Also, further research could include document analysis with more rigor, especially on the lecturer's feedback on the research participants' writing. And also, for further research, researchers could utilize other ebook writing software other than iSpring. There are many other ebook writing software or applications such as StoryJumper, Storybird, Flipsnake, Anyflip, and so forth. So here comes the conclusion. Conclusion number one. Treatment group outperformed the control group in this study, in which, you know, the treatment group utilized the ebook writing software to produce ESL liquid writing. Number two, this affected positively the pre-service teacher's academic writing performance, with the increase of pre-service teacher's writing ability, then only, okay, there's possibility for these pre-service teachers to impart their writing skills to their future students, learners, pupils, when they are being placed in primary schools nationwide later on. And this study proposed effective ways of enhancing the writing process by making the writing process more evident with its recursiveness. Thank you so much. I guess that's all for my presentation today. Thank you so much again for having me. And if you do have any questions, do feel free to contact me. I am Dr. Kili Lee from Institute of Teacher Education Malaysia, Tun Hussein On Campus. Thank you so much.
Terima kasih diucapkan kepada Dr. Kili Lee di atas perkongsian itu sebentar tadi. Semoga perkongsian sebentar tadi dapat memberi manfaat kepada kita semua. Terima kasih saya ucapkan kepada semua yang setia menonton dari awal hingga ke akhir rancangan ini. Terima kasih juga saya ucapkan kepada pihak urus setia di belakang tabir dan kru penerbitan yang telah menjayakan program ini. Sebelum saya akhiri webinar kali ini, izinkan saya menyampaikan serangkap pantun. Bunga dedap di atas para, anak dusun pasang pelita. Kalau tersilap tutup bicara, jemari disusun maaf dipinta. Sekian, wabillahi taufiq wal hidayah. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.